In resurrection, actual appearances of Jesus work out better than a hallucination hypothesis. So you said, how do I confirm that Paul saw the risen Jesus? You know, if it were just Paul on that, I'd say, well, perhaps it's a hallucination, okay, if it's just Paul. If it was just Peter, I might say, well, maybe that was just a hallucination. You can come up with these different kinds of explanations, but the historian must look at all the data, and that's what explanatory scope is. And I look and I see, all right, Peter said that he had an appearance of Jesus. Paul, and Paul wasn't even a disciple. He hated Jesus. Jesus would have been the last person Paul would have wanted to see or expected to see. Paul was not grieving over Jesus' death. Here's a group appearance over here to 12. Here's another group appearance that's being claimed by the earliest Christians. You start to look at these and say, okay, well, group appearances are implausible. The appearance to Paul would have been unlikely. And then you got all these, you put together and say, well, what's the best explanation? In resurrection, actual appearances of Jesus work out better than a hallucination hypothesis. So that's where historical method comes in. I may not be able to look at a single data and say, I can prove it based on that. But I look at all of the data and say, this is the best explanation for it.
All right, was that a question? I mean, I can comment on it. I'll wait for my question.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's your question time.
What do you think of that?
Okay. Thanks. What I think of that is that in order to say that the resurrection is the best explanation for these facts, first of all, you have to demonstrate that resurrection is, in fact, a plausible explanation, that it's something that could happen.
Which we did.
When did we demonstrate that it's possible to be resurrected?
We looked at the supernatural dimension. There's four evidences right there. And certainly, if there's a supernatural realm, you'd have to say that resurrections are possible.
Oh, no, I don't accept that there's a supernatural realm. Second of all, if in fact there is a supernatural realm, that doesn't mean that resurrection is possible.
Okay.
Maybe there's a supernatural realm and resurrection is impossible. But I find it strange that we're talking about, you know, getting messages from the other side. That's something we could potentially test for. And yet what we have is fake psychic after fake psychic over and over again doing this.
Yeah, we do, but just because there's a lot of counterfeits doesn't mean there aren't authentic ones. There are plenty of
authentic
ones.
And so how do you tell
which ones? 300 of them.
So you say there's 300 authentic. How do we verify that these are actually what they claim to be?
Because there's this corroborated data from at least one external source.